This unspeakable gift which he has given, Jesus Christ is his name. Blessed be God. Father, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for the name. We thank you for your son. We thank you for the gift. More than that, we thank you for the understanding, the revelation, the hearing of your word that told us about the name, that told us about the gift. And we thank you that our hearts did understand what our ears did hear. We thank you that you brought understanding to our hearts and we acted upon it. We called upon the name. We believed. We received. And so therefore, we can walk in the light. We can walk in the Spirit. We can walk in the might. We can walk in the things of God in the name, casting off the things that are of the night. We walk in the Spirit. We walk in the light. The Word of God is a lamp to our feet, the light to our path. The Word of God shall endure throughout all ages. When others fail, that alone will last. And the Word of God has been given. The Spirit of God has brought the revelation. And the name of Jesus is the name that makes it good in your heart, in your life. You receive what you believe by the name. And that name is Jesus. Can you just raise your hands again and say his name? That name is Jesus. Jesus. Every knee bows, every tongue confesses at the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. Cast out devils in the name of Jesus. Well, that's anything of the devil. That especially is in your life. When you can help somebody else, especially if they'll receive it, if they'll believe it. If you were to just go around casting out devils out of everybody, most of them come right back because they want them anyway. But especially that means in your life and anything of the devil, sickness, disease, command it to go in Jesus' name. Tumors, go in Jesus' name. A growth, go in Jesus' name. Germs, viruses, bacteria, that is unhealthy and unproductive. I understand some bacteria is good. But anything that's unhealthy and unprofitable, not good. Every germ, every virus, every disease, every bacteria that's not good. When you touch my body, you die in Jesus' name. See, I'm using the name of Jesus. Tumors and growths, you die, dissolve, dissipate, disappear. All those disses. Disease, disappear, dissolve, dissipate, disappear in the name of Jesus. Sometimes it's instant, sometimes it's little by little. Well, don't you believe that'll come back? No, I don't believe it'll come back. And if it were to try, I'd talk to it again. Well, you know, that's incurable. Well, in the natural, that may be true, but I don't believe that. Well, that's hereditary. Well, in the natural, that may be true, but I don't believe that. They say this virus. Some say this, some say that. Well, you can get it again. Well, I don't believe that. I'm not going to get it in the first place. And if it tries, it did try, stuck around for a day or two, maybe three. But I didn't slow down. I did what I was supposed to do. But somebody said, well, we have people that were under the effects of it for more than just a few days. Well, keep growing and keep saying the right things and it'll be better next time. Everybody say it'll be better next time. Well, that may come back. Don't believe that. See, if you believe that, you invite it. You're actually opening the door to it. Well, they say you can get that again. Well, don't believe what they say. That'll open the door. That'll open the door. So what you say, and then use the name of Jesus. Well, the world may get it, but not me, in the name of Jesus. Because I'm in a new family. I've got a new immune system. I have a spiritual immune system. And then faith works by love. Check it out. Do you have any unforgiveness toward anybody? You've got to walk that out. You can tell what people believe by listening to what they say and watching what they do. And monitor your own life. Watch what you say yourself. Watch what you do yourself. And then things are progressive. I love Charles Capp's experience. I don't mind telling you I'll never have poison oak. And then he went out to hunting and he came back with poison oak or poison ivy. They told him, you see, it doesn't work. People all the time trying to convince you it doesn't work. Well, it won't work for them. They'll have what they say and they say it doesn't work. Jesus said you'd have what you say. They say it doesn't work. Well, it doesn't work for them because that's what they say. Turn that around. In the old days, we had records. You could turn it over and play the flip side. You need to play the flip side of that record. Turn that over. It does work. And that's what Charles Capp said. It does work. It is working. Faith is coming. And he kept saying it. Well, it took 3 years before he actually could go out where it was. He said, you know what I do now? If I see a tree that would make a good deer stand and it's all covered over with poison oak or poison ivy, I just take out my pocket knife and I go down at the base of the tree and cut that vine and strip it off with my bare hand, and I don't get it. I used to get it. If I just got around it, I'd get it, but I don't get it. Took 3 years of saying it, but I don't get it. It doesn't come on me. And what do you, well, in the name of Jesus. That's not coming on me in Jesus' name. And then if it were to try, no, you don't. No, you don't. Get off of my body. You're a trespasser. You don't belong here. You're not attaching yourself to me. You're not staying in Jesus' name. Had a growth on my finger. That took a year. I talked to it every day. I didn't miss a day. I didn't miss a day. Most days, lots of times. But I didn't miss a day. You're not staying in my body. You have to go in Jesus' name. Nothing changed for 3 months. Then it started to go down little by little by little by little by little for another 9 months, took a full year. Then after that, a couple of months later, it tried to come back. There it is. My, you're not coming back on me in Jesus' name. That took a couple of days. Then a few more months later, tried to come back. There it is again. No, you don't. No, you don't. You're not coming back on me, and it's never tried since. If it were to try, just talk to it again. But I'm using the name. Jesus said, whatever you ask in my name, I'll do it. That's in your own life. That's in service ministering to other people. And Jesus also said, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it you. And let's just go ahead and believe that. There is power in the name. Do you believe that? Say it out loud. There is power in the name. Well, I'm not going to get that. The world may get it, but I'm not going to get it. And if it's already in your body, I'm not going to keep that. The world may keep it. They may say it's incurable. They may say that once you get it, you'll always have it. They say some viruses are that way. Once you have it, you'll always have it. It may be dormant, but it's always in your body. You see, I don't believe that. That may be true in the natural, but I don't believe that. I'm supernatural, thank you very much. I'm supernatural. Can you say amen? Turn and tell your neighbor, I'm supernatural. Tell your other neighbor if you've got one. If you don't, tell the same neighbor, you're supernatural. Let's all say it, we're supernatural. We walk in the supernatural. Well, the name is supernatural. The world can't use the name and it work. Those seven sons of Sceva, or Siva, however you pronounce it, they tried to cast the devil out using the name. And they said, we adjure thee in the name of Jesus whom Paul preacheth. Somehow they had heard about the name, but it didn't work for them. It didn't work for them. It worked for Paul, but it didn't work for them. The name is supernatural, works for supernatural people who it belongs to. Well, they weren't even born again. You have to be in the family for the name to work. Somebody say amen. And then you've got to be in right standing. Faith works by love for the name to work. And then you've got to believe it for the name to work. But we are supernatural beings. We walk in love. We have faith by the word. And the name works. I expect it to work. In fact, some things I'm surprised. Are you still here? I see you, but I don't believe you. You know, I expected that to be gone weeks ago. Now, that surprises me. But it's going. Somebody say, it's going. Why? The name. the name, not my power. It's not our might. It's not our power, but it's His Spirit, and His Spirit is activated by the name. Blessed be the name. It's the Word and the Spirit, and we operate in the name. In Him we live. In Him we move. In Him. Well, who is Him? Who is Him? What's His name? In Jesus, I have my being. I'm in Him, and He's in me. Well, it's sort of like the Trojan horse. They saw that Trojan horse, and they thought it was a gift they were accepting. But on the inside of that Trojan horse was something they didn't see. Well, if I have the armor of God on, and I've got my helmet in place and the breastplate in place, and the devil can look at me, but he sees I've got the armor of God. I'm on the inside. The armor of God is what he sees. And then he's on the inside. If it were to be the devil says, I know who you are. Well, do you know who's in me? I have power that you maybe don't see. In the name of Jesus, you go from me. And you know what happens? I sit to submit to God, and you know what he does? He just has to flee. And then thank God for victory. Isn't it good that we're in him? I'm glad he's in me. And I talk to the devil and just watch him flee. What did I do? I used the name. I used the name. Sickness, you go from me. Oh, you know, this that was on me for 3 days. I didn't expect it for 3 days. It's like, are you still here? Well, I'm going to get up and go do what I need to do, but I'm surprised you're still hanging around. You can't stay here. You can't stay here in Jesus' name. Somebody say, in Jesus' name. And then meditate on it. Think on it. He said this. He said, whatever I ask. He said this. He said, I cast out devils in the name. And that's anything of the devil, too, which is disease, sickness and disease. He said I could use his name. I didn't say it. He did. I'm not making this up. It's his idea. He must want me to do it. I think some children of God don't use the name enough. Amen. And in the name of Jesus, you go from me. And then expect it to happen. Is that right? Blessed be the name. Let's say it again. Blessed be the name. At the name of Jesus, every knee will bow. Every tongue confess of things in heaven, things in earth, things under the earth. Every knee will bow. Every tongue will confess. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I meditate on that. Whatever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it you. My. How tremendous is that? Whatever you ask in my name, I'll do it. My. How tremendous is that? You mean if I say in the name of Jesus, you go, it's the same as if Jesus said it? Well, will it come to pass if Jesus says it? I think that way. As he is, so are we in this world. He said, I'm not even going to pray the Father for you. He loves you already. You don't have to come to me, and I'm not going to pray for you. The Father himself loveth you. And whatever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it you. What he means is, that's in John 16. What he means is, instead of coming to me and me asking, you go to the Father yourself. And it'll be the same. It'll be exactly the same as if you come into me and asking for it, and I respond. But see, in that day, you won't come to me. You'll go to the Father yourself, but you use my name. And he didn't say maybe. He said he'll give it you. And then he talked about joy. He talked about joy. Everybody say joy. He said, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he'll give it you. Hitherto have you asked nothing in my name, but ask. Ask. And in the Greek, it's emphatic. It's please ask. There's some intensity. Ask. It's like he could raise his voice a little bit. Raise his eyebrows. Ask. Make a gesture to emphasize this. In the Greek, it's emphatic. Hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. Ask. How? In my name. And you'll receive, and your joy will be full. That's what he said. Your joy will be full. That's what he said. It just blesses me to know he wants my joy full. That blesses me. You mean he's interested in my joy? He must be. He told me to ask so that my joy would be full. You mean he doesn't want me to have blue Mondays? Could I have joy on a Monday? He doesn't want me to have a bleak day. He wants me to have joy. He wants me to ask and he wants me to receive so that my joy would be full. I remember where Paul in Ephesians 6 talked about the evil day, but he told us what to do. So we'd have the outcome, so we'd have results, and so that the evil day would be replaced by the joyful day. Can somebody say amen? I think some people ought to be about ready to have the evil days replaced. Aren't you ready to have the evil days replaced? Well, he told us what to do. He said, ask and you'll receive that your joy may be full. Well, it works by believing it. Somebody said, I don't believe that. Well, it won't work for you. Somebody said, I tried that. It didn't work. Well, it doesn't work for people who just try it. It works for people who believe it and persevere and endure, don't cast away their confidence. They hold fast to the profession of their faith. They don't get weary in well-doing. It works for people who let patience have the perfect work. It works for people who won't waver. It works for people that persevere. It works for people who believe the name of Jesus is just like Jesus asking it. And it works for people who believe. Say it out loud, I believe. So it works for me. Well, what is it that you want? Ask. What is it that you need? Is there a promise in the word? Then ask. What's come against you that's contrary to the word? Then talk to it, speak against it, command it to go in Jesus' name. You come out of my body. You go from my circumstances. You get out of my house. Satan, take your hands off of this area of my life. I command you to go in Jesus' name. And then meditate on it. Jesus said he'd do it. Jesus said my Father would do it. Jesus said it would be done. And then just rejoice and thank God for it and see it happening. In your innermost being, the eyes of your spirit, see it happening. And act like you believe it's going to happen. Why, you'll never, there's no cure for that. Well, I've got the cure. I don't always tell everybody because you cast your pearls before swine, they turn and rend you. Let them find out later. Maybe sometimes I tell the testimony or you could tell the testimony or we tell people. Then they still don't believe it. That's an amazing thing to me. But they try to talk you out of it. You just stay with it. God's word says, I'm supernatural. This may be natural, but I'm supernatural. Some people work in the natural field. Medical people have to work in the natural field. They deal with natural things. I mean, if gravity works, if I had a ball in my hand and I threw it up in the air, it'd come right back down. People who fly airplanes have to deal with the natural. They know gravity works. They've got to do something to supersede that. Well, in the natural, there are things that work, so we have to do something to supersede it, to override it. I'm supernatural. Not everybody is. The seven sons of Sceva, they tried to cast the devil out, and that demon-possessed man beat them up. Is that right? They fled naked. In the Greek, the word naked sometimes means with their underwear. I hope they did. But he tore their clothes off and they fled, whipped, beaten, and naked. Seven men tried to cast the devil out of this one demon-possessed man, and it did not work, even though they used the name. Even though they used the name didn't work for them. Why? They didn't believe it. They weren't even born again. They even spoke that we're using the name that we heard about Paul speaking. And so the devil spoke up and said, well, Jesus I know and Paul I know. Actually, the Greek says Paul I've heard of. I've heard of Paul, but who are you? See, you're not even a child of God. You don't have the right to use the name. Well, I am a child of God, and I have a right to use the name. And in the natural, this may be incurable, or this may have natural repercussions, but I am supernatural. And the name of Jesus gives me a priority, gives me the ability to overcome what's in the natural. It has to bow its knee. And then medical people and natural people and scientists can just stand back and be amazed and try to figure out a way where they can explain it that makes sense to them. Sometimes they just can't come up with anything. Sometimes they even say, well, that's a miracle. We have no explanation for that. We can't explain that. But I can. I can. Jesus is supernatural. Amen. Do you believe that? Say amen again. Jesus is supernatural. Brother Hagin, one of my favorite quotes, he was in a meeting in California when the flu was going around. And they closed the school. And in the meetings, the daytime meetings, there's just a handful of people that came. Everybody's staying away because of the flu. And so after the day service, he's talking with, it's just a few people that came, and it's him and a couple of other ministers. And another minister, a Pentecostal minister, said to him, Brother Hagin, aren't you afraid you'll get the flu? And he said, now he's talking to a minister. You don't go around and tell this to everybody because they don't understand. But he's wanting to help him. So he said to him, I don't mind telling you, I'll never have the flu. And he came up to his side and whispered in his ear, Brother Hagin, I'd never say that. Whispered in his ear, I'd never say that. Don't you know the devil will hear you? Don't you know the devil will hear you? Pentecostal pastor, don't you know the devil will hear you? Don't you know the devil will hear you? Pentecostal pastor, it bothers me sometimes when I hear ministers and Christians and Pentecostal ministers and Pentecostal Christians talk about the work of God, and then they can't just leave it alone and talk about the work of God. They got to talk about the devil. Anytime you do something for God, don't you know the devil's going to attack you? Why do you have to put that in there? Just talk about the work of God. You know that, you know, anytime you do something for God, the devil's going to attack you. And then they spend the next 15 minutes talking about the attack. We're out there trying to work for God. Oh, we're just struggling. We're just, struggling to get through the heat and the cold and the fire and the wind. We're just trudging through the mud. We're out there trying to do something. We're trying to do something for God. But don't you know, anytime you do something for God, the devil's going to attack you. I wanted to get up and walk out. I'm sitting there in the congregation listening to that. Wanted to get up and walk out. You got to talk about the work of God and then end up the devil, the devil, the devil. Well, sure, sure, but who cares? Why do you care? I couldn't care less if I tried hard. I don't care. I have power over him. I've got power to tread upon serpents and scorpions, and I have power over all the power of the enemy. This shield of faith quenches all the fiery darts. What do we care what he does when we've got the power over him? Don't you know the devil will hear you? And he said right out loud, yeah, yeah, I know the devil will hear me. That's why I said it. I want him to hear me. He's the very dude I want to hear. I want him to hear me. I don't mind telling you, I'll never have the flu. And then a few days later, it tried to get on him for an hour and a half. But he said, no, you're not going to come on me. And he used the name. Everybody say the name. He used the name and then faith in the name. What is his name? The name of Jesus. What's his name? Jesus. Can you raise your hands one more time and let's just bless his name. Thank you for the name. Thank you for faith in the name. Thank you for victory in the name. Thank you for the name. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. All hell trembles, but in heaven they are assembled because of the name. You see hell tremble, but in heaven they are assembled because of the name. The name causes a different reaction in the two realms. In heaven, there is the assembling, but in hell, there is the trembling. Not only are the saints of God assembled, but the angels of God assemble. When they hear the name, the angels assemble to cause the work to be done, and all of hell does tremble. Two reactions when that name is spoken by faith. Two reactions. In hell, there's trembling, but in heaven, there's assembling. You speak the name and then imagine, just see behind the scenes what's happening. I'm speaking the name, faith in the name. What's happening behind the scenes? What's when it's by faith in the name, without wavering, a faith which works by love. What is happening when I speak the name? In heaven, there's an assembling. There's a call. The bugle has sounded. There's a call to arms. There's an assembly. There's a dispatch. Angels are dispatched. The plan of God is dispatched. There's a response in heaven to the call of the name. There's an assembly. There's an assembling. But in hell, there's a trembling. We have to go. We have to obey. I don't want to. I'd like to stay. But he used the name and I have to go away. Submit to God and he'll flee. And what's left is joyful victory. I like that. I like that. There's an assembling. There's a trembling. I like that. I like that. Both are happening. There's an assembling. There's a trembling when we use the name. In Psalm 91, there's a phrase there that says, because he has known my name. Why are all these things happening? Why are all these blessings in our lives? Because of the name and knowing the name. Knowing the name. Those seven sons of Sceva didn't know the name. Oh, they knew of the name, but they didn't have the right. But my, for those of us who are called children of light, we have the right to use the name. I like that. There's an assembling. There's a trembling. I like that. That which is necessary to bring the thing to pass is assembled and dispatched. There's a call. There's a call to go forth and cause it to come to pass. I like that. And in hell, there's a trembling because they know when heaven hears the call, hell has the fall. their plan is brought to naught. And they are dismayed. And they flee in fear. The power of God is wrought. The plan has been made. And we see it happening. And then we say, it's here. Glory to God. I like that. There's an assembling and a trembling. See it. When you speak the name, don't just use it as a rabbit's foot. A good luck charm in your pocket. I'm going to use the name. No, have faith in the name according to the word. Use the name and then see with the spiritual eyes. There's a reaction now. I've spoken the name. There's a reaction. Heaven reacts. Hell reacts. And things are now in the works. Things are happening that you don't see. Things are happening that you don't see. Things are happening that you don't feel. It's happening now because I spoke the name. It's happening because I spoke the name. Amen. Amen. Say it out loud. It's happening. It happens when I speak the name. Blessed be the name.